speak student.
Equivalent ratios and proportions, a la Shmoop. Well, Bobo is having two of his chimp friends over for a nice casual banana dinner. He's already set the table and placed a gourmet meal of 5 bananas per chimp on each plate. You know, bananas have appeal. Suddenly, the door opens and 22 chimps come flooding in. Bobo's buddy Bam Bam, say that 3 times fast, says, "Hey, sorry, brought a few of the guys from the office. Hope you don't mind." Okay, so now Bobo has to serve bananas to all these other chimps. Hopefully there are enough in his pantry. Using the same ratio of banana to chimp that Bobo was using initially, how many bananas will he need now? Well, this is a perfect example of equivalent ratios. We know exactly how many bananas will feed 3 chimps. Now we just need to figure out how many are needed to feed 23. And don't forget Bobo, these hungry, hungry monkeys, right? Okay, so chimps aren't monkeys. You got us. Hope you're proud of yourself. All right, well, the ratio of bananas to chimps is 15 to 3. Since Bobo put out 15 bananas to feed 3 chimps, got it? It simplifies to 5 to 1, meaning 1 chimp eats 5 bananas. Now that there are 23 chimps, we can show the equivalent ratios like this, where B is the number of bananas needed to feed everyone. Now we simply multiply on both sides of our equation to clear out the denominator. Well, 23 times 5 is 115, and boom, we've got our answer. We could have done the same thing if we'd left our fraction unsimplified. In that case, we would have had 15 over 3 and b over 23. Well, multiplying both denominators away, we'd get 3b equals 345. Then divide both sides by 3, and we get b equals, yep, still 115. Well, as it turns out, Bobo has 110 bananas in his pantry. He feeds everyone except Bam Bam. Yeah, those two aren't speaking at the moment. Things are a little tense.